want that whole place on fire. They want to put radicals in because then the globalists can invade and clean out the radicals in each country and fully take it over. And then roll in with the sterilants, the vaccines, the fluoride, the water, the GMO crops like they've done in Iraq. And give them the same death they're giving us. They want a captured group where they can brainwash them with Western media. BBC and the U.S. government just merged as a way to launch propaganda internationally. They were already merged. Google, the head of Google now, they're saying is going to be the head of the Commerce Department. It's all government. You read at SPP, North American Union, internal documents the Judicial Watch student got 4 years ago. At those meetings, the Fortune 100 order the presidents and the Secretary of States and the heads of the Energy and Commerce Departments of every major nation. They tell them, do this, and they ratify it. They take direct orders. The liberals are like, good, tax the corporations and give it to the people. That just goes to the government and goes to the offshore corporations. These corporations are government. They are the government, the illegitimate, stinking corporate government. 200 years ago, the British East India Company was a private government running India and countless other possessions across the Pacific. It's the British East India, Dutch East India Company model. Okay, that's what globalism is. That's what the New World Order is. Here it is. Wave of unrest shakes Syria. Crowds torch party HQ. Definitely special force led, just like it was a month ago in Libya. Are we going to now have our government tell us, our corporate government, we've got to invade? You notice the ceremonial Congress wasn't even involved in this. The corporate UN set up by the Rockefellers ordered it last Thursday. It happened in 48 hours. Will the corporate UN, prancing around posing as liberals, running genocide, will they now call for an invasion of Syria? What about Bahrain? CNBC. I know good old boys are like, good, kill them. Bahrain's our allies, Dumbo. Bahrain King says forces have foiled foreign plot. It's all coming up.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hello, friends. This is Alex Jones. You've heard me talk about Calbin 5-star soaps for years. This is an American-made product of the highest quality and compares to nothing you will find in stores. You can buy factory direct, shipped via UPS right to your door. Check them out on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091. Take my word for it. Once you've used Pure Soap, you won't buy anything else. Since 1947, Calbin Soap Company has been showing consumers that soap can be tough on dirt and gentle on the environment. Buy American and stay clean, as well as support InfoWars. Visit 5starsoap.com today or call 1-800-340-7091. Well, Marty, what do you have to say?
As founder and owner for over 63 years, satisfaction is guaranteed or double your dirt back. Call us at 1-800-340-7091 for a free catalog or visit our website, 5starsoap.com. Thank you.
Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress. And they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a Fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at InfoWars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Alex has told you that the Mideast uprisings over food prices and shortages caused by fuel costs are spreading worldwide. We're seeing the impact right here in the United States. Ethanol that was supposed to reduce petroleum use and fuel prices hit a 30-month high in February, and pump prices are expected to reach $5 a gallon. Because of shipping costs, food is being priced out of the reach of millions of Americans with an expected 35% jump in the next 60 days. Move quickly while you can still afford it, and eFoods Direct Direct will pay your shipping costs for you. For the best tasting, long-term storable food, you pay nothing for shipping and can put every dollar into food at today's prices. eFoods Direct, food so delicious you can serve it tonight or save it for the future. Take advantage of free shipping by calling 800-409-5633 on the web, efoodsdirect.com/Alex, 800-409-5633, or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
You take them all, the man, and put them in control. Watch him become a god. Watch people's heads roll.
What have we told you in the last few years that the globalist stratagem was? That as they build towards the world meltdown of financial markets by design and the public birth of private corporate world government issuing the new global currency, the SDR. What have we broken down that they would do? That what did Webster Tarpley, who I want to get on in the next few days, guys, go ahead. In fact, even in the last hour today, if you can get Tarpley, I meant to tell you. What did Tarpley say the Brzezinski model was? He's written countless white papers, books. He's told us what he would do. He's running foreign affairs for Obama for behind the scenes. Destabilization. Wars, breaking countries up, financing rebels, and then when the rebels fail, you move in behind them in the name of dealing with a humanitarian crisis. We have called this 100%. What did I say a few weeks ago? That they would attack Gaddafi, that that was coming, and then they would stage terror attacks and say that Gaddafi had done it as a pretext to launch a full-bore ground invasion of the entire Middle East, every, quote, enemy rogue nation, but also go after the globalist big enemy, the Western populations that are their milk cows that they're bleeding dry. And now the New York Times says U.S. eyes, Gaddafi terror response, U.S. intelligence agencies are watching for signs that desperate Colonel Muammar Gaddafi, under attack from a coalition air assault, could resort to acts of terrorism against Western targets. See how perfect this is? And then if he fights back, it's called terror. Or if he, even if he doesn't, they'll stage something. The globalists for years, at least five they admit, have been trying to get the Iranians by attacking them internally through terror groups to respond. This is very sinister. U.S. officials are keeping an eye on that possibility, one U.S. official said. Colonel Gaddafi has extensive stockpiles of mustard gas, high explosive at his disposal, that could be used in attacks against targets in Europe or against his own people. He has also a documented history of orchestrating strikes against civilians and other world leaders. All right, now, here's the most important point that people need to be made aware of. What is the Western ally Bahrain saying that just defeated with Saudi Arabian troops a massive uprisings nationwide, many of them violent? Bahrain King says forces have foiled foreign plot. Oh, who do you think was behind it? Bahrain's king, Hamad bin Isal Al Khalifa, said a foreign plot against his kingdom had been foiled and thanked troops brought in from neighboring countries to help end increasing unrest after weeks of protest. But again, when he shoots peaceful protesters, it's loving and good in our media. At least for now. Will they call for an invasion of Bahrain? They didn't call for an invasion of China after Tiananmen Square or the ongoing stuff in the last 20 years. The king told forces that if such a plot had succeeded in one Gulf country, it could spill into neighboring states. Well, of course, that's the plan. The ferocity of the crackdown last week by Iranian forces, aided by the entrance of troops from the Sunni-ruled Gulf countries, stunned Bahrain's majority Shiites, the main force of protest, and angered the region's non-Arab Shiite power, Iran. So they're claiming, they're trying to imply Iran's the power. Iran, which supports Shiite groups in Iraq and Lebanon, has complained to the United Nations and asked neighbors to join in urging Saudi Arabia to withdraw forces from Bahrain. Now, what's going on to the west of there in Syria, north of Israel. Wave of unrest shakes Syria. Crowds torch headquarters. Crowds set fire to headquarters of the ruling Ba'ath Party in Syria and city of Dara on Sunday. Residents said as a wave of unrest in the Arab world shook even one of the most authoritarian states. The demonstrators also set ablaze the main court complex and two phone company branches. Yeah, they knew exactly what to hit. Special Force commanded. One of the firms is owned by the president, Assad's cousin. They burned the symbols of oppression and corruption, an activist said. The banks nearby were torched. So you've got all these dictatorships run by independent dictators or run by Western-backed dictators. And so when the Western-backed dictators kill people and shoot them, it's loving, good, helpful, pro-America. But when it's Libya or when it is Syria, it's horrible and we've got to invade. And when I say we, again, that's my own brainwashing from the globalist. It's not our government. It's not our military. Get that through your heads as we go bankrupt. And remember all those Obama memos, all those White House advisors saying we need a new 9/11. We need a new Oklahoma City to blame on domestic groups and a 9/11 to blame on foreign groups to keep the wars going and to make Obama's approval rating go up. We need these events. Remember the Giffords shooting. Within hours, they were blaming it on talk radio. Ron Paul, Alex Jones, Rush Limbaugh, Sarah Palin. As the internet kill switch goes into place, all of this happening now, all of this unfolding, with British and other Western special forces on the ground marking and lasing targets of the ongoing bombardment, with Gaddafi handing out over a million weapons to over a million citizens preparing for the ground assault. And the globalists are happy to just split off the eastern part of the country, encircle Gaddafi, and then launch more guerrilla attacks over the years. But they may actually stage a terror attack. Remember in the few months before 9/11, even the Time magazine and Newsweek reported on this, the week after 9/11, 44,000 U.S. troops, 18,000 British troups, several aircraft carrier groups, the aircraft at land bases as well, all got ready, and Bush signed the order to attack Afghanistan on September 10th. In fact, guys, search the term Bush signed order to attack Afghanistan on September 10th. The first link will be Newsweek. I'm going to put that on screen for folks from 2001. They won't believe it unless they see it. A lot of them won't even search it. They'll just won't believe it. So you got all the troops already built up in the name of dealing with Egypt. You've got the amphibious ships that just arrived this week, dispatched 3 weeks ago, the amphibious Marine Corps ships, these big stub aircraft carriers sitting there waiting to disgorge Marines. You've got Illinois National Guard being dispatched to the region. Headline, Illinois Guard heads to Libya. An Air National Guard unit out of Illinois is heading to Libya to help fight against Colonel Gaddafi. I am proud of the National Guard. That means U.S. aircraft in the air launching bombing attacks. I am proud the National Guard is able to play a part in curbing the atrocious violence against Libyan civilians by their own government, said Major General William Inrant, the adjunct general of the Illinois National Guard, in a statement. Oh, really? Is a foreign government going to invade the U.S.? Headline, U.S. Army kill team. It's turned out that was lies about